Blackstone Audio and Skyboat Media present The Mystery of Choice by Robert W. Chambers. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. Introduction. 1. Where two fair paths, deep-flowered and leaf-embowered, creep east and west across a world concealed, which shall he take who journeys far afield? Canst thou then say, I go, or I forego? What turns thee, east or west, as thistles blow? Is fair more fair than fair, and dost thou know? Turn to the west, unblessed and uncaressed. Turn to the east, and seated at the feast thou shalt find life, or death from life released. And thou, who lovest best a maid dark-tressed, and passest others by with careless eye, canst thou tell why thou choosest? Tell then, why? So when thy kiss is given, or half forgiven, why should she tremble, with her face flame hot? Or laugh and whisper, Love, I tremble not. Or when thy hand may catch a half-drawn latch, what draws thee from the door, to turn and pass through streets unknown, dim, still, and choked with grass? What? Canst thou not foresee the mystery? Heed, for a voice commands thy every deed, and it hath sounded, and thou needs must heed. RWC, 1896. The White Shadow. We are no other than a moving row of magic shadow shapes that come and go round with this sun-illumined lantern held in midnight by the master of the show. A moment's halt, a momentary taste of being from the well amid the waste, and lo, the phantom caravan has reached the nothing it set out from. Oh, make haste. Ah, love! Could you and I with him conspire to grasp this sorry scheme of things entire? Would not we shatter it to bits, and then remold it nearer to the heart's desire? Fitzgerald. The White Shadow. Listen then, love, and with your white hand clear your forehead from its cloudy hair. 1. Three great hulking cousins, said she, closing her gray eyes disdainfully. We accepted the rebuke in astonished silence. Presently she opened her eyes and seemed surprised to see us there yet. Oh, she said, if you think I am going to stay here until you make up your minds.
I've made up mine, said Donald. We will go to the links. You may come.
I shall not, she announced. Walter, what do you propose?
Walter looked at his cartridge belt and then at the little breech loader standing in a corner of the arbor.
Oh, I know, she said. But I won't. I won't. I won't.
The uncles and aunts on the piazza turned to look at us. Her mother arose from a steamer chair and came across the lawn.
Won't do what, sweetheart? She asked, placing both hands on her daughter's shoulders. Mama, Walter wants me to shoot, and Don wants me to play golf, and I won't.
She doesn't know what she wants, said I.
Don't I? She said, flushing with displeasure.
Her mother might suggest something, hazarded Donald.
We looked at our aunt.
Sweetheart is spoiled, said that lady decisively. If you children don't go away at once and have a good time, I shall find employment for her.
Algebra? I asked maliciously.
How dare you? Cried Sweetheart, sitting up. Oh, isn't he mean? Isn't he ignoble? And I've done my algebra, haven't I, Mama?
But you're French, I began. Donald laughed, and so did Walter. As for Sweetheart, she arose in all the dignity of 16 years.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.